Because one thing, I'm still stuck in menopause. I hate that. I have paused on menopause. I'm time for somebody to push play or fast forward or something. No, pause. You're here till Jesus comes. I am so tired. This is my 6th year in menopause. I know. I've called the doctor. I've done everything. I've taken the hormones. I quit the hormones. I take the herbs. I quit the herbs. I took some herbs, and I don't even... I mean, you drink the tea. There's all these for me. You drink some tea. Here's this lotion. Now, my mom says, you put this lotion on, turn to the west. And then you won't have me anymore. I mean, I tried everything, you know, just everything. I got on, like, rounds and rounds of ginkgo biloba. Couldn't remember. I think that's how you say it. It's supposed to help your memory through menopause. I just don't remember where I put it. I mean, it's just been miserable. Menopause. It's the truth. It's pitiful. And I sweat. I sweat for no reason. I don't dream about exercise. I wake up sweating. You're laying in a puddle, glistening in the night. What did the husband think? Ooh, like he still got it. Let me tell you boys something. Those night sweats have nothing to do with you. Little egomaniac. I can't sleep. I don't sleep. That's what you don't sleep in menopause. You just toss and turn and sweat. You get up and change your pajamas. You get back in the bed. You toss and turn. You sweat. It's pitiful. And you know, my husband, after 30 years, I've been married 30 years to this man for 30 years. Don't clap. You don't know him. Isn't it funny? I love a room full of Christians. Some will laugh and some will go, oh. We should laugh at that. You can laugh at that. I've said that to his face. Now, he sleeps good for some reason. You know, as he gets older, he just sucks the walls through his nostrils. That was my dream as a young girl. Didn't you want to just grow up and marry a rootin' pig someday? Like he's trying to talk to me. And like an idiot, you went, did you say something, dear? What? But he does. He snores so good. I mean, just... And you guys are so funny. You come waltzing in the bedroom with your black socks and your tidy-whities, scratching your beer gut. Hey, honey, got on my lucky pair. Can I just tell you something about your lucky pair? If your waistband is up here and the rest of your drawers is drooped down there, those are not lucky. That's a piece of trash. Phone closed and you hold these up going, why do I bother folding these? He will actually come to you later and ask you, where's my lucky pair? I wanted to throw them out. I thought, well, you know what I'll do? I'll just use them to wash the car. I went outside. The car backed up. Don't touch me with those drawers. Y'all waltzing in there and you're like, if you can count the scratch marks on the back of your drawers, throw them away. They're not lucky. They're not lucky. They're not tempting. They're nothing. And I don't know if it's like me, but now we're at this stage in our lives where we try to race to bed. You know, we race to get to sleep. The first one to get to sleep, you know. If I can just get to sleep before he does, then I'm okay. But if he starts snoring, I ain't getting to sleep. Because there's just something aggravating. It's just that whole menopause mood swing or something about his snore that just crawls up your neck and you find that filler in your... And young girls, that's why you need Jesus before you get to menopause. If you don't know Jesus before you get to menopause, somebody in your house will die. It's just disgusting.